Greetings to my pastor and First Lady Strode and my St. Paul family. Good morning, and thanks everyone for joining us for worship service today, live on Zoom. We are celebrating Pastor's Appreciation Day in honoring Pastor Strode and First Lady Shelby Strode. I'm Rochelle Holloman, and I will be serving as your worship leader today.
Amen.
The announcements. Please keep your devices on mute so that all participants can enjoy their worship service today. Please join us for Pastor's Bible Study on Wednesday at 12 p.m. and at 6 p.m. We are studying the rapture that is in the book of Revelation, chapters 4 through 6. Also, please join us in celebrating our 200th church anniversary next Sunday on August the 23rd at 11 a.m. Bishop Leaf will be bringing the message for that day. Ross Greenfield WMS will be meeting on Saturday, August the 22nd at 10 a.m. on Zoom. And the Women's Missionary Night in White will be held on August the 29th at 5 p.m. on Zoom. These are the announcements for today. Please remember to pray for our known sick and shut-in, Sister Paulette Coleman, Sister Lizzie Connor, Sister Marion Dunn, Brother Maurice Dunn, Reverend Barry Frazier, Brother John Fullwood, Sister Lillian Gentry, Sister Carolyn Higgins, Sister Marjorie Johnson, Sister Nancy Miller, Sister Wanda Thomas, Sister Anna Walker, Sister Joanne White, and Sister Viola White. The doxology. Praise God from whom? We will now have the call to worship. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Our feet shall stand within thy gates, O Jerusalem.
For a day in thy courts is better than a thousand. I had rather be a doorkeeper in the house of my God than to dwell in the tents of wickedness.
Because of the house of the Lord our God, I will seek thy good.
Those that be planted in the house of the Lord shall flourish in the courts of our God.
Blessed are they that dwell in thy house, Lord. I have loved thy habitation, the place where thy honor dwelleth.
For the Lord is in his holy temple. Let all the earth keep silence before him.
Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer.
O sing unto the Lord a new song. For he has done marvelous things. Make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all the earth, and sing praises.
We will now have our morning hymn, O Give Thanks. O Give Thanks unto the Lord. This is by Dr. Judith Christie McAllister, and we do not own the rights to this music.
Come on, everybody, put those sanctified hands together and give God the praise in this place. If you come to give him thanks, stand up on your feet and let's honor him this morning. Hallelujah. He's worthy this morning. Bless the name of the Lord Jesus. Come on. Let's sing it. Oh, give thanks.
To the Lord, for he is good.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
God is good. And he's
good.
Good.
Thank you, Lord.
We will now have the prayer by Asiah Robinson.
Amen.
May you please bow your heads. God, pray for the virus that is going around. Pray for the ones who have passed. Also pray for the ones who have the virus and pray that we get through this. Amen.
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 He is Lord. Testament reading by Sister Kendall Smith.
I'll be reading the Old Testament, Jeremiah chapter 3, verses 15 through 16. And I will give you pastures according to my heart, which shall feed you with knowledge and understanding. And it shall come to pass, when ye be multiplied and increased in the land, in those days, saith the Lord, they shall say no more, the ark of the covenant of the Lord, neither shall it come to mind, neither shall they remember it, neither shall they visit it, neither shall that be done any more. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading of his holy word.
Amen.
I'll be reading.
And we will now have the epistle reading by Sister Shelby Holloman.
I'll be reading the New Testament. 1 Theologians, verses 3 through 6. Remembering without ceasing your work of faith and labor of love and patience of hope in our Lord Jesus Christ, in the sight of God and our Father, knowing, brethren, beloved, your election of God, for our gospel came not unto you in word only, but also in power and the Holy Ghost, and much assurance, as ye knew what manner of men we were among you for your sake, and ye became followers of us, and of the Lord have received the word in much affliction with the joy of the Holy Ghost. May the Lord add a blessing in the hearing to his words. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
We will now have a gospel reading by Sister Simone Smith.
I will be reading Romans chapter 10, verses 13 through 15. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. How then shall they call on him who they have not believed? And how shall they believe in him of whom they have not heard? And how shall they hear without a preacher? And how shall they preach except they be sent? As it is written, how beautiful are the feet of them that preach the gospel of peace and bring glad tidings of good things. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading and the hearing of his holy word.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
We will now have the summary of the Decalogue by Sarah Lee.
From all that dwells below the skies. And he said to them, you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind. This is the first and great commandment, and the second is like unto it. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. On these two commandments hang all the law and prophets. The Glory Pot.
Thank you.
Amen. Good job.
So we will now have the selection, Grateful by Hezekiah Walker, and We Do Not Own the Rights to This Music.
Gratefulness.
you, Lord.
Oh, amen. Grateful. So on behalf of Pastor's Appreciation Day, in honor of Reverend Strode and First Lady Shelby Strode, the Steward Board, along with the St. Paul family and many families, family and friends, are going to present you with a small appreciation from us.
That's nice.
Congratulations, Dr. Strode, on this time of appreciation. I want to extend greetings to you and to the historic St. Paul family. We are glad that they are acknowledging your service. And so Supervisor Susan joins me in praying that God will bless you and Sister Shelby with strength and wisdom as you lead the people with love. God bless.
Amen.
To Bishop Leith and to Dr. Susan Leith, to all of the members of this great historic church, and special greetings to Pastor and Lady Strode on this, your day of appreciation and love, and on Pastor, your 67th birthday. Please enjoy a poem I wrote several years ago. When your days come in which you need to be reminded that your life has meaning and you are indeed gifted, creative and valued. And whether God has given you unfathomable blessings, breathe slowly, breathe deeply. Listen to the Spirit and hear someone calling your name and giving thanks for you. May your days be filled with grace, peace, and joy. And may you continue to serve your God in this church. Have an awesome day.
Amen. God bless you.
Greetings in the wonderful living name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ to our friends Pastor and Mrs. Strode. Surprise! Someone told Bishop Few and me that this was Pastor's Appreciation Day, and we would just like the members of St. Paul AME Church, Lexington, Kentucky, to know just how much we appreciate the fellowship and the friendship that we have had with the Strodes for over 40 years. To maintain a friendship that long in this day and age is nothing short of a miracle. So to Pastor and Mrs. Strode, sit back, breathe, and enjoy this wonderful day in your honor. And remember, God is doing a new thing for your ministry. Perceive it and receive it. And by the way, happy birthday, Pastor Strode.
Greetings to Reverend Dr. Robert A. Strode.
God bless you.
Mrs. Theora Bird, retired Episcopal Supervisor. Greetings and congratulations upon another successful conference year at historic St. Paul African Methodist Episcopal Church, Lexington, Kentucky. You have always been and still are an extraordinary pastor, preacher, teacher, and advisor. I know for certain that under your anointed preaching and committed leadership, souls are being saved, and members of your church and Lexington community have been encouraged to care for one another during this trying time in the history of our country. When I was the Episcopal Supervisor of the blessed 13th Episcopal District, I always admired your stellar reputation, your integrity, and wonderful spirit of cooperation. You truly are one of your district's outstanding pastors. Your partner in ministry, the fashionably Effervescent, outgoing First Lady, Mrs. Shelby Strode, is also to be commended for making a difference in the lives of others. Her acts of kindness and generous hospitality are a special gift that has been appreciated by me and other supervisors. I still have that beautiful hat she gave me. Please enjoy the service of appreciation and your birthday celebration. You deserve it. Love you both. Mrs. Theora L. Bird, retired Episcopal supervisor.
Man. Oh, Jesus.
Dr. Strode, our life's journey has been intertwined for as long as I can remember. Too many years for either of us to begin counting now. As we continue to lift the kingdom of God together, I want to take this moment to tell you how grateful I am for your mentorship and leadership, your teaching and preaching that has blessed my life and ministry, and for your encouragement and support every step of the way. May your appreciation be truly blessed, and I pray God's continued grace upon your life and your family and your ministries. Blessings, Dr. Strode. Blessings.
Thank you.
Praise the Lord, Reverend Dr. Strode. The Bible declares that the steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord, and he delights in his way. And your steps have truly been ordered by the Lord. You have invested so much in the building up of the body of Christ. And so this is your day. I say to you, happy pastor's appreciation from myself, my husband, and from Keon. God bless you. Love you, Sister Strode. Love you both. Love and you enjoy too. Your day. God bless.
Thank you. Thank
you. Jesus. Pastor.
Jesus.
Dr. Strode and First Lady Shelby Strode, I greet you with Jesus' joy. On behalf of me, Reverend Sherry Green, and my husband, Brother Sam Green, and the flock at St. Paul AME Church, Manchester, Kentucky, we would like to wish you a very, very blessed Pastor's Appreciation. I thank God for an opportunity to be able to just say, God bless you. And we've been friends down through the many years. May you have a great, wonderful day this Sunday. And Jesus loved you, and we love you too. And as Nehemiah said, you're doing a great work, and I know you won't come down. We love you. God bless you both.
Oh. Hello, I am Louise Spencer. I'm the pastor of Wayman Chapel, AME Church in Barberville, Kentucky.
I'm Percy Spencer, the pastor of the Big Chapel AME Church in Salvisa, Kentucky. We would like to express our sincere and heartfelt congratulations on your pastoral appreciation. Thank you so very much for your words of encouragement as well as your friendship. May God continue to richly and abundantly bless you and your lovely spouse now, henceforth, and forevermore.
Amen.
Greetings. First Lady Mrs. Shelby Strode, officers and members of historical St. Paul African Methodist Episcopal Church, Lexington, Kentucky. It is a joy to share with you on this special occasion the appreciation of your pastor, who is worthy of this recognition. My good friend, Dr. Robert A. Strode, a servant of God, a spiritual leader, humble and very orderly. I pray God's blessings will continue to be with you as you continue the great work at St. Paul and throughout the 13th Episcopal District. God bless, God keep you.
God bless you.
Strode, you are highly appreciated as a pastor, preacher, teacher, counselor, administrator, and theologian. You have proved through the years of your ministry that you are a great shepherd to God's people. And on a personal note, you are my friend, and you have been a bonhomous to me, encouraging me through the toughest of times. Enjoy your special day, and I pray you have many more years serving God and his people. May God's favor continually fall on you, Shelby, and your work in the Lord's vineyard. St. Paul is blessed to have you and Shelby.
Oh, Uncle what?
To nephew, and I hope you have a very happy birthday. We're very happy that you are a member of our family. You're married to my niece, Shelby. Congratulations. Hope you have many more birthdays. Thank you.
Amen.
Hello, everyone. God be the glory, not just for today, but for every day. I would like to wish Reverend Strode and First Lady Shelby Strode a Pastor Appreciation Day. I will not say this name again because I'm going to call him my brother, my sister. I want you to know that I'm very proud of you, how God has used you over the years, and you wouldn't be as good as you are if you didn't have Sister Strode by your side. But trust and believe, you were destined for this job. And I like to thank you, let you know I appreciate both of you all for the joy and the blessings and the teachings that you are giving to everyone along with myself. God bless you. And thank God that the Lord let you see another year. You are very much appreciated. Love you, brother. Love you, sister.
Love you, babies.
And may this be a joyous occasion for you all.
Oh, happy birthday, Uncle R.A., and happy anniversary. Oh. I wish I could be there with you and Aunt Shelby, but I know, you, as you know, this COVID's got us all, but I just want you to know that I love you all from the bottom of my heart, and you have a beautiful day, because if no one deserves it, you do, and I love you. This is your niece, Teresa. Have a good one.
On this Pastor's Appreciation Day, we thank Reverend and First Lady Strode for being an inspirational example of love and lifetime commitment.
You were there as a son on wedding day 25 years ago, and again this year with the renewal of our vows. Thanks for being a great inspiration and a great faith leader.
Mr. Strode, I have many memories of our time spent as undergraduate students at Kentucky State University many years ago. You have always been there for our family during our times of grief to strengthen our faith and provide us hope that everything will be all right going forward. For that, I'd like to thank you again. We are extremely proud of the man, teacher, and pastor you've become and wish you greater success with your ministry and all future endeavors. We love you and appreciate everything you do and have done for us. Enjoy your pastoral celebration.
Dad, this is just a wonderful opportunity. I just wanted to take this opportunity to say happy, happy birthday to you. There's no one who deserves a good and a happy birthday more than you do. So on behalf of Joy Richardson, Naomi, RJ, and myself, we just want to say happy birthday. You've been so much to so many through the years, not just as a father in the ministry, but as a father figure and someone to just show love and to embrace, you know, young men as they're matriculating through the ministry and just trying to learn about life. You've been so much to me and to my family, and we just want to take a moment to say happy birthday to Reverend Dr. Robert A. Strode. God bless you and God keep you is our continued prayer.
Amen. God bless you.
Hello, my name is Reverend Fonseca Frazier. To the Reverend Dr. Robert Anthony Strode, on behalf of the ministerial staff at Historic St. Paul African Methodist Episcopal Church, we will want to thank you for your service and leadership that you have given to this great Zion of heaven. I'd like to thank you for the doors and the opportunities that have been opened and that you have allowed us, and we would ask that God will continue to bless you richly in your ministry.
This is Myron Coleman, Co-Kim of Historic St. Paul AME Church and his congregation. We would like to say, Reverend Strode, that we love you, and may the Lord continue to bless you and exhorter Shelby Strode on this Pastor's Appreciation Sunday.
Amen.
Happy Pastor's Appreciation to the love of my life, and happy 67th birthday to the love of my life. I am just so blessed to have spent most of this time with you. I thank you for being the husband that you are. I praise God for you. I'm glad you found me, because the scripture says, he who findeth a wife findeth a good thing. And I'm so glad that I was found by you. Now, you might wonder, why isn't Shelby doing a video? That's because every time I try to do one, you popped up. So I'm sitting here in the walk-in closet with the door closed. And this is the best I can do. But at least you get to see me in real life, hopefully for many, many, many more years. I praise God for you. I pray that God will continue to bless your ministry. I pray that you will continue to preach an uncompromising gospel, for you are a preacher who's not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ. I praise God that I have shared in ministry with you for so many years, and I thank God that I am here to celebrate your birthday with you. Honey, you still looking good, still got that baby face, you got it going on, my boo, my boo, my B, my O-O-O. I love you, my darling. And have a great day.
Oh. Pastor Strode and First Lady Strode, once again, we just want to say thank you, and we love you.
We love you.
It is now time for tithes and offering. The officer of the day is Sister Kyla Jackson.
This is the time during worship you can participate by giving. You can give using the following methods: check or credit card, by phone, by calling the church at 859-255-7945, leaving your name and number at the finance team will return your call. Visit the church website at stpaulame.org, then select donate and click on tithes and offering. If you have set up your account on Breeze, then you can give through Breeze by following the link on the church website, Breeze Church Membership. Or finally, text by dialing 859-209-6003. Donations can also be mailed to the church address at 251 North Upper Street, Lexington, Kentucky, 405507. Reminder, we asking each member to give $1 for every year towards our 200th church anniversary held on August 23rd for a total of $200.
Amen. All things come of thee, O Lord.
The sermonic selection by First Lady exhorter Shelby G. Strode, and we do not own the rights to this music.
There's not a friend like the Lord, like the lowly Jesus. No, Juanita. No, not one. None else can heal.
Oh, Jesus.
All of your souls. These diseases. No, not one. No, no, not one. Jesus knows all about.
Yes, he does.
And he will guide until the day. The day is done. There's not a friend.
Yeah.
I love Robert Strode, but like the low, like the lowly Jesus,
no,
not one, no, not one. There's not an hour that he is not near us. Dr. Redia, no, not one. No, not one. So dark, but his love, Sister Bessie, his love can cheer us.
Yes.
No, not one. Not one. Jesus, yes, he knows. He knows all about. He knows what you're going through. He knows. He knows.
Yes, he knows.
The low, No, not one.
Amen. Amen. The message for today will be presented by Exhorter Doris Coffey.
Amen. Use the Lord.
Good morning.
Morning.
To God be the glory for the things that he has done. What a blessed and great day this is. Not only is it the day the Lord has made, but it is a day of worship and praise, and it's our pastor's appreciation. What an honor to appear before you today and bring the message on this day of celebrations. Allow me to extend a warm welcome to each of you for tuning in to our service.
Amen. We
trust you enjoy our witness to the goodness of God. We seek God's presence as we commence this day to be with us and to guide us so that we may finish this day well. So feel welcome to our service and enjoy this appreciation day. Let us pray. Father, we come to you this day, seeking guidance and wisdom, giving thanks for your many blessings. We thank you for the dawning of a new day, the opportunity to worship and praise you. We give thanks for our pastor and pastors everywhere. Thank you for giving us pastors. Mm-hmm. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. This I pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Pastor's Appreciation Day is a day set aside to remember our pastor and how God has used him to be beneficial to our church. Along with thanks, we praise and glorify God for his accomplishments thus far and look forward to many more. For kingdom building never ends on earth. So we've gathered this morning virtually as a show of solidarity toward Pastor Strode, who has dedicated his life to the ministry of the Lord. And we celebrate this day by offering a special tribute to him because of his faithfulness to God, his selfless service to the church and church family. So this morning, I want to talk from the subject, and God gave us pastors.
All right.
With the text coming from Jeremiah 3:15, which reads as follows. I will give you pastors according to my own heart, which shall feed you with knowledge and understanding. Pastors are a gift from God. God gave us pastors because we need pastors. They're commanded to teach God's word. The office of a pastor is to deliver, expound, and explain God's words to his people. So we need pastors to help us in our Christian walk. We need pastors so that the people may be trained and prepared to do the work of the ministry and build up the body of Christ. God has given pastors a heart to love the people, a heart that is open, not just for compassion, but for empathy, a heart to care for people during trials and troubles in their lives, to be with people as they walk through the journey of losing a loved one, to be with families who struggle financially to make ends meet, to be with a heart that is open to those who are seeking to follow Christ. What an awesome responsibility that is. Far greater than preaching. And certainly preaching is the heart of every pastor. It is the love that radiates and permeates in the life of God's servant. Now it has been said, people will soon forget a sermon no matter how good it is. But they will never forget a pastor who has been with them during the difficult times in their life. Pastor Strode has been consistently with us through good times and bad. You may ask, why celebrate Pastor's Appreciation? Well, we celebrate because there is a difference between appreciation and gratitude. Appreciation is about acknowledging the perceived value of something or someone. but gratitude is a response for what someone has done for us or about feeling thankful. Appreciation is about having admiration for others and communicating your approval to them. It is taking the time to make people feel welcome, special, to encourage and uplift them. Appreciation can make us feel happier, more inspired, energized, and loved. It's about valuing others. Appreciation is fueled from heartfelt thanks to God, realizing what we have and what he has done, for the relationships, opportunities, and blessings he gives. Appreciation is essential for showing God's love and is one of the most powerful yet overlooked aspects of successfully motivating and empowering people. So let us not get too preoccupied with ourselves and our circumstances that we can't appreciate and value others. Let us not be so consumed with gaining respect for self that you can't give respect and honor. God cares how we treat other people. Showing appreciation may be trivial, but to God it is very significant and can be a way he uses to lead people to Christ. Scriptures point out how valuable it is to God that we take time to honor others. A kind word at the right time can lead a person out of depression, out of a bad situation, even suicide. Your kindness sets a tone for healthy relationships and the ways of Christ. So how can we be more appreciative? Take time to voice sincere compliments, write a note, celebrate victories, make people feel special. The idea behind Pastor's Appreciation is to thank God for the provision that he has given us through the preached word via our pastor. Showing appreciation for the pastor is a good thing. He needs to be appreciated. And what's more, he wants to know he's appreciated. Everybody wants to feel appreciated. But it's also commanded in Scripture. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verses 12 and 13 reads, "Brothers and sisters, I ask you to acknowledge those who work hard among you, who care for you in the Lord and who admonish you. Hold them in the highest regard and love because of their work." In the Bible, the Lord often expressed his appreciation by giving people credit, praising them for their good qualities or making right decisions. The Apostle Paul wrote several letters showing his appreciation to others. In fact, there's numerous accounts of other people showing their appreciation. Romans 13:7, "Render therefore to all their dues, tribute to whom tribute is due, custom to whom custom, fear to whom fear, honor to whom honor." Revelation chapter 2 and 3 tells of how the Lord faithfully shows appreciation for our good qualities, even while convicting us about our sins. So we should never fail to show our appreciation to the Lord by praising him for all he's done for us, or to each other for what they've done for us. So we extend our sincere appreciation to Pastor Strode for things done in our church, recognizing that it is only through Almighty God that he was able to do so. And God gave us pastors. A pastor's responsibility is far greater than you may think, for it is the responsibility to watch over our souls. Every church, whether large or small, needs a pastor who will shepherd, lead, and guide the people to spiritual growth and service for the Lord. It's one of the greatest privileges to be a pastor for Jesus Christ. The work is vitally important to the success of God's church. For he teaches the word, he demonstrates the love, and leads the people. Pastors are an important part of the church. Pastor Strode, thank you for the work that you do, for feeding us and nurturing us and guiding us, and sharing the word of God in its complete message from Sabbath to Sabbath. Thank you for being tenderhearted and compassionate in the face of grief and joy filled as you share in our celebrations. Thank you for choosing to follow God's calling on your life. And you know that it's all worth it as you choose daily to take up your cross and follow him. Thank you for allowing God to minister through you. Thank you for your compassion and empathy, willingly given in times of need. Thank you for your spiritual leadership and guidance. Our congregation is blessed for it. Thank you truly isn't enough. Today we honor you for all you do, for the years you have poured into ministry, for the word you spread and the lives you touch. We cannot thank you enough. As you go about the work of pastoral ministry, be mindful that the head shepherd is constantly by your side.
Oh, yes.
Strengthen, encourage, and guide you. God has called you, and his orders are clear. Mm-hmm. Preach the word. Be ready in season and out of season.
All right.
Convince, rebuke, exhort with long suffering and teaching. And while you are preaching the word, remember that the ministerial staff, the officers and members of historic St. Paul African Methodist Episcopal Church are right there with you.
Thank you.
Now you all need to understand. Today is not only about him, but it's also about her. First Lady, yeah. Shelby Jean Strode. They are a team. Being a pastor's wife is a high calling, but it's also a great responsibility and a great blessing. Our First Lady is a godly woman with such grace, always a smile on her face and a warm greeting. She's always encouraging. She's such a lady. She's everyone's friend. She serves with love and joy and has a heart for the people. First Lady Shelby, we are honored this day to show you love and appreciation for all of your hard work and dedication. Being our First Lady is a blessing that is not unspoken. You have stood faithfully along the side of the man of God with love, support, encouragement, and faith, setting an example of true commitment to him and the work he's been called to do. We know the wife of a pastor is no ordinary role, and it's not for the timid soul. So I take this moment to say we celebrate you. You are a sister in Christ. We love and adore you. We realize your hands are never ending and recognitions are few. Still, the beauty of your soul shines through. Your smile speaks volumes. You are charming, graceful, talented, confident, smart, and pretty. We, the St. Paul Church family, love you. May God continue to bless and keep you standing in the gap for our beloved pastor. Because behind every good man, there's a good woman. And today it is none other than First Lady Shelby Jean Strode. Jeremiah 3:15. And I will give you pastors according to my heart, which shall feed you with knowledge and understanding, with things worthy to be known and understood, with solid and substantial truths of the gospel. Pastor Strode, as our pastors, we're ever so thankful. Our congregation has many blessings for the significant role you play. Your words of wisdom and unwavering faith uplifts us. Your hard work and sacrifice are appreciated. May the people be blessed as a result of your proclaiming the glorious gospel of Jesus Christ, that others will come to know him, love him, and serve him. Now, who of you remembers 2, 4, 6, 8? Who do we appreciate? All together now, we love you, Reverend Anthony Strode. And First Lady, Pastor Strode.
Love you.
May the Lord keep you always. We praise God and glorify his name forever and evermore. Thank you, my fellow brothers and sisters in Christ. Stay safe and be on guard. Appreciate those you love. Show them. God is about care. God would have us care about each other. He would have us show each other that we love him. Yes, he would have us to help and lift each other up. Pastor Strode, First Lady Shelby Jean, we love you and we love you.
We love you.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Glory to God. Glory to God. Beautiful.
Amen.
So beautiful.
Thank you, Exhorter Doris Coffey, for an excellent word. We appreciate you. I now would like to present to you Pastor Strode.
Amen.
Thank you, Exhorter
Coffee, for that wonderful message. Amen. Beautiful.
The great shepherd gave his life for all of us.
Yes.
By dying on the cross. And when he died on the cross, he made it possible for us to have eternal life. And when Jesus died, he said, Jesus gave his life.
Temptations on every hand.
For the invitation now
is Satan's try.
Lord Jesus Christ, we invite you today.
And to place my feet on sinking sand. Oh, Jesus, 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 Jesus.
Apostles' Creed.
And now for the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker in heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born in a virgin Mary, suffered under the Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he arose from the dead, he ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Church Universal, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sin, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
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 I would just like to take this time right now to say thank you for allowing me to serve as your worship leader today. It has been my pleasure and my honor to do it. I would also like to thank all the families and friends who've come out and celebrated with us today, as well as allowed us to help pull this wonderful service together for Pastor Strode and First Lady.
God bless you.
We will now have the doxology, followed by the benediction and any closing remarks by Pastor Strode.
And now unto him that is able to keep you from falling and to present you faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy, to the only wise God, our Savior, be glory and majesty, dominion and power, both now and ever. And everybody said, amen. And then I will close us out.
This is truly the day that the Lord has made, and I tell you, I'm rejoicing and I am so glad. I just praise God for all of you. I want to thank the committee. I want to thank Sister Rochelle. You have done an awesome job as the worship leader. I don't even know where to start, where to finish, and I'm just overwhelmed right now. This is just a wonderful, wonderful occasion. I think there's a scripture that says that a prophet hath no honor in his own country. It's kind of asking that question. And St. Paul, your loving spirit has proved that that isn't necessarily always the case, because we have come home. And I've been at St. Paul since, 1955, up until I married. And you all are just wonderful, wonderful people. You're not just people. You are our family. I want to thank everyone who participated, our family, our friends. I think I saw Uncle Walter, Teresa, Cheryl, Pete. All of you are here. I don't like to get into calling names because you're going to forget someone. But thank you all so much for your words. And one thing about our family, we're not in Luana. How can I forget Luana, our baby sister? In our family, if you notice, we don't say in-law a lot because we are just family. And I'm just so overwhelmed right now. I want to thank Reverend Fonseca for the prayer this morning and getting us started. So many people are here. Some of our friends from Louisville, I see them. And I want to say to my pastor, you all know how I am. I will just talk and talk, especially when I'm excited. I just want to thank you for being a true man of God. And on Sundays, when I say amen and praise the Lord, that's because you're the same man at home that you are in the pulpit. And I just thank you for being a wonderful person. I love you, Sister Doris. You are just amazing. You're going to have my head so big until it's not going to fit into any more of my hats anymore. But I know you meant that from your heart. I think you've left, but I will call and tell her. Thank you all so, so much. I love each and every last one of you. Thank you so, so much. If I forgot you, it's in my head and not my heart. I love all of you, and I pray that the peace of God that surpasses all understanding will be with you.
Close, I want to thank Sister Strode for all of the years of service, and I love you, and I appreciate you, and I thank God for all that you mean to us. You have been so good to us, and I appreciate you, and especially to me, because you have been everything for me, and I appreciate you, and I want everyone to know that I love you, and I appreciate you and all the work that you do. And you also hid a lot of stuff for me.
You kept hanging around. I had to do everything in the walk-in closet.
Thank you, Sister Rochelle, and the committee, and the steward board, and the church, Sister Paula, all of you who put together this worship. You did an excellent job. And yeah. I appreciate you so much.
Beautiful.
Who has participated in the worship, all of my friends who
came
in, and without calling any names, I'm sure I will respond in a more personable way. And I want to, surprising me about my birthday, combining you all are so special, and we appreciate you, and we love you, and we know that God is working through all of us to do what the Lord wants us to do. So I appreciate you, and I love you. Don't think it robbery because of what you're doing. It's very important that you try to hide things from me, but it's very important. It's very important. Meaningful to me, and I'm so emotional right now that I can't even think right. So I love all that you're doing, and we appreciate it.
My sister, her husband is a minister, he's a bishop, and she's an evangelist, and they just sent words to say that they love you and happy birthday, and that they are so proud to have you as their brother in love.
Church anniversary.